you very much indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening and welcome once again to another show. Just remember, it's 3-2-1 you're on. Right about this time, we'd like everybody to sit back, relax and enjoy themselves, because as usual, we have our package of prizes, personalities and puzzles, plus our prime prize, the car. But popping up will be a problem, our booby prize, Dusty Bin. But I've not seen him all day. I know George is here, my chauffeur. George? Ah, now George, she's terrific, you know. I mean, if I want to go to the shop, she drives me to the high street. If I want to relax, she drives me to the coast.
Mr. Rogers, the pubs are open. Do you want me to drive you to drink?
No, thanks, George. The show's doing that already, thank you. Just go and look and find Dusty, will you? He's about somewhere.
Dusty's over there, reading his fan mail.
Fan mail? He's not getting fan mail already. Yes, he is. Look at this. Yorkshire TV Leeds. What have we got here? Oh, yes, look at that. There's a photograph of some children from the Alsford County Primary School. They've decorated their dustbins to make them look better than you, Dusty. He's not the only good-looking dustman in the business. OK, George, get rid of him. We'll see him in the car a bit later on in the show. As you can see, folks, we've got a marvellous studio audience here, and they come from all walks of life. We have a party over here from Wimpy's, the builders, and we've got a group over here from Wimpy's, the caterers. They're going to merge and build the world's first 18-storey beef burger. Got another group here of bookmakers, that's right. And who's this group next to you here? Turf layers. Oh, bookmakers and turf layers. Odds and sods. That's nice. But as you know, on 3-2-1, we start with three couples in the quiz. The winners of the quiz always come back next week. Two couples then compete in a game. We're leaving one couple to go forward for the really big prizes. And although we have big prizes on the show, remember, it's still possible to go home with a pound note and a dustbin. But we do start with our 1001 quiz. Our couple's already chosen their questions in front of the studio audience, and our adjudicator is there to check her answers. She will indicate on the board how they're doing, but if they make a mistake, that's when they hear from our three frantic funsters and their gruesome gags. Dougie Brown, Chris Emmett and Debbie Arnold. I can only ask our couples to get their answers right, otherwise we've got to put up with them all night. But come along right in the aisle now and meet my gorgeous secretaries of the gentle sex and our very important people, our contestants. This week, our couples are from the Midlands, Yorkshire and Essex. So let's get straight on with our quiz. Meet Holly Allen Smith with the questions. How are you, Holly?
Fine, thank you, Ted.
Lovely to see you again.
And there's, of course, it's Patsy with you know who. Chris and Roger from Essex back for the 6th week.
That's right. But I think both of us are becoming full-time quiz contestants.
I'm pretty sure they are at this rate. Lovely to have you back again. 6 weeks running. How much have you won in all?
£1,700.
£1,700. That's not bad, is it, really, when you think? And Chris, you have a big affiliation with people down there in South Wales. Originally, you come from Swansea. What about you, Roger? You lecture in law. Now, what does that exactly mean?
Well, I teach in a technical college, and I teach, well, nurses, district nurses, midwives, and so on, that kind of thing.
Mm. What do you teach?
Well, have babies legally. I know.
As long as it's legally, let's keep it that way. There's their... the second and third round questions. Thank you, Patsy. Now, you know how the game goes, of course, but for everybody else, this is the easy round of questioning. We want them to do well, of course, in the first round, because the amount they win in the first round is the amount they're playing for each correct answer in the second round, likewise the third. We like them to answer alternately, Chris first, Roger second, and so on, but we do stop them if they make a mistake, repeat an answer, or indeed if the time runs out. There are many answers to these questions, but we only want 10 in 30 seconds, all right? So good luck to you both once again. Here's your first question for a pound. I will give you one to start with. This question is about signs and symbols that can be made by a standard typewriter. We do not want the letters, numbers, or fractions. We want the signs and symbols which are used for punctuation, etc. If one symbol is used for several purposes, we only want it once. For instance, dash, hyphen, minus sign, all right? So punctuation signs and symbols of the typewriter, the one I'll give you to start is dash.
Dash.
Question mark.
Full stop.
Semicolon.
Colon.
Apostrophe.
Comma.
Stroke.
Equal sign.
Quotation marks.
Well done indeed. They did indeed. They got a maximum on that time. Time out, but you scored a maximum. £10 a question next time they're playing for. Well done, Roger and Chris. Now, lovely Jenny Leyland. Thank you, Jenny. And Gail, who are our next couple?
Here is Malcolm Pinder and his friend Pamela Wilson, who are both from Yorkshire.
Malcolm is the area manager for menswear boutiques, and Pamela is a medical secretary.
Oh, lovely. You've always there. Second and third round questions. Will you take this, please? Thank you. So, Pamela and Malcolm. Malcolm, nice to have you here.
Thank you.
Oh, you manage men's boutiques, is that right?
Yeah.
Do you know, I was voted third best dressed man last year. I was really happy until I found out I was beaten by Patrick Moore and Columbo. Anyway, Pam, I see here that you work in a hospital,
that's
is that right?
That's right, I work in the professorial unit.
In the professorial unit. And what exactly does that
mean? Well, you don't teach professors.
No?
No, it's linked to the university.
I see.
For teaching facilities and this sort of thing.
Because they do great work, hospitals, there's no question about that. Yes. But they have a sense of humour too, don't they?
Oh, yes, indeed. I think perhaps more so in that sort of job than in a lot of others.
Let's get into your first set of questions. Playing for a pound, and good luck to you both. Answer alternately, you know what you have to do. This question is about announcements and advertisements in daily newspapers. We want the names given to the columns in daily newspapers where they can pay to have announcements and advertisements printed. All right? So names of announcements and advertisements in daily newspapers. I'll start you with births.
Births.
Deaths.
Personal.
In memoriam.
Marriages.
Court and circular.
Mistake!
These newspaper holiday advertisements anymore. I mean, last year I went to the Canary Islands and there were no canaries there.
Yeah, I know. I went to the Sandwich Islands. There were no sandwiches.
Just my luck. I've just booked for the Virgin Isles.
Oh, well. Jenny, how well did they do?
Pam and Malcolm have scored five.
They scored five, thank you. Yes, because there was a mistake. You said court and circular. You don't pay to have that put in the newspaper. Nevertheless, £5 you're playing for each correct answer in the next round. That's great. Holly, next set of questions, please. Thank you very much indeed. And Mireille, who are our third couple tonight?
This is Brian Lewis and his wife, Linda, who both come from Sutton Coldfield. Linda is a housewife and mother of one child. And Brian is a chartered surveyor.
You got it right this week. She said shattered the surveyor the other week. Never mind. Would you take the second and third round questions? Can I have that there, please? Thank you. Well, Brian and Linda, nice to have you here. That's good. A chartered surveyor. So you work for the council, do you?
No, private practice.
Private practice.
I sell houses.
Oh, you sell houses? You're making a fortune these days, aren't you? Because I read somewhere that they've gone up 18% last year alone, is that right?
I think that's probably about right.
I mean, at that rate, if you sold your house today and bought it back at night, you'd need a bridging loan, wouldn't you, really? Gosh. Anyway, and Linda, what did you used to do?
I used to be a consumer advisor for the county council.
Does that cover everything, consumer advising?
More or less, yes.
Prices?
Yes, prices, shopping.
Food prices?
Yes, all sorts
shopping,
of things.
Huh? Mm. How do you find the shopping prices? Dreadful, huh?
I think they're worse now on this side of the fence than when I was working there.
I'm sure they are. Because my mother, you know, she swears she's getting stronger. She reckons 20 years ago she couldn't carry a pound's worth of groceries home, and now she can. Anyway, nice to have you here. Good luck to you two. You're playing for a pound for each correct answer, and we want you to answer alternately. Here is your question. This is a question about major divisions of the compass. If you consider there are 16 commonly used points of the compass, we want you to give us 10 of them, all right? So points of the compass, we'll start with north.
North.
South.
East.
South, southwest.
West.
North, west, west.
Mistake!
I say, waiter, there's something funny about this crab.
Something funny? Impossible. The scriptwriter just cooked it.
Holly, how did they do?
Belinda and Brian have scored five.
They scored five. In fact, Brian, because you said northwest, west, and in fact, it should have been west, northwest. Well, that's it. Punch him, Linda. Give him one. That's it. Never mind. What do we have then at the end of our first round? We have two couples, number three and number two, on £5, but in the lead at the moment, couple number one on £10. Yes, Roger and Chris. There we go. Thank you, Patsy. Getting to be a habit, isn't it? It really is. £10 a question, this time you're going for. There are 22 teams in the first division of the Football League as at the beginning of next season, autumn 1978. We want 10 of them, all right? So teams in the first division of the Football League, I will start you with Leeds United.
Leeds United.
Manchester United.
Liverpool.
Manchester City.
Arsenal.
Everton.
Derby.
Birmingham.
Aston Villa.
Coventry.
Well done there.
Well done indeed. I'll tell you why well done. You did say Derby, actually, Chris. It should have been Derby County, but the adjudicator has allowed that. So once again, you've scored a maximum. That means you're playing for £100 for each correct answer next time. Well done. Gail. Thank you. Okay, Malcolm and Pam, good luck to you. You're playing for £5 for each correct answer. Now, there are 17 cricket teams that take part in the first-class county championships. We want 10 of them, all right? So teams in the county championships, and I'll start you with Middlesex.
Middlesex.
Yorkshire.
Derby.
Lancashire.
Peterborough.
Hey, Chris, ask me if I've got a gag about cricket. Go on. Go on, ask me if I've got a gag about cricket. Go
All
on.
Right, have you got a gag about cricket?
No, I'm stumped.
Jenny, how well did they do?
Pam and Malcolm have scored 4.
They scored 4, in fact, because, Pam, you did say Peterborough.
I did,
and there isn't
yes.
a Peterborough Shire or County Cricket. I'm sure there's a Peterborough Cricket Club somewhere, but not in the County Championship. One. Never mind, you scored 4, which means 4, you're playing for £20 a question. Next time, you could have said Sussex, Essex, Glamorgan, Kent. There were many more, but £20 a question next time. Good luck to you. All right, the second set of questions, Renee, thank you, for Brian and Linda. You're also playing for £5 for each correct answer, and good luck to you. Your question is, there are 17 national Formula One Grand Prix races whose results count towards the Drivers' World Championships. We want 10 of them. So national Grand Prix races using the names which show the country. And let's start with the Spanish Grand Prix.
Spanish Grand Prix.
South African Grand Prix.
British Grand Prix.
Canadian Grand Prix.
French Grand Prix.
German Grand Prix.
Swiss Grand Prix?
Mistake!
My boyfriend told me, he said, I've never kissed a girl in a car before, but I knew he was lying.
How'd you know that?
Well, he changed gears with his knees.
Holly, how well did they do?
Linda and Brian have scored 6.
They scored 6, yes. Because, of course, Linda, you did say Swiss Grand Prix.
Well, that's his fault.
It was his fault, that's it. Smash her up. Swiss isn't counted, of course, in the World Driving Championships. Nevertheless, that's 6. Of course, 6 fives are 30. So at the end of the second round, we have couple number 2 on £20, couple number 3 on £30, but also in the lead again, number 1, £100. Yeah! All right. Thank you, Patsy. So, Roger and Chris playing for £100 for each correct answer. Is it possible to get £1,000? Nobody's ever done that on this show. Now then, for your question, third round. We want nuts that are commonly eaten in this country. Cobnuts and filberts are, in fact, hazelnuts. All right? So, nuts commonly eaten in this country, I will start you with hazelnuts.
Hazelnuts.
Walnut.
Brazil nuts.
Peanut.
Cashew nuts.
Maple nut.
Mistake! And now from one nut to another nut. Big Jim.
Good evening. Now, I know a lot of you think I'm not serious about this 5% business. Well, I am serious. Only this morning, I spoke severely to the cabinet, had a harsh word with the dresser, and stuck me tongue out of the wardrobe.
Ah! All right, Jenny, how well did they do?
Roger and Christopher scored 5.
They scored 5, because, Roger, we haven't really heard, or our adjudicator hasn't anyway, of a maple nut. There might be one somewhere, but we haven't heard of it. Nevertheless, you've scored 5, £500 you have there. Right, the last set of questions, Gail, please, for Malcolm and Pamela. You're playing for £20 for each correct answer. Here's your third set of questions. We want fruit that is frequent... we want fruit that you frequently find stored in the kitchen to be used in cooking, both dried fruit and fruit that is preserved by sugar. We do not want the range of crystallised fruits that are eaten uncooked as a sweetmeat or tinned fruit, but dried and preserved fruit used in cookery. OK? So dried fruit and fruit preserved by sugar. Let's start with... Prunes.
Prunes.
Apricots.
Raisins.
Currants.
Sultanas.
Peaches.
Mm-hmm.
dried bananas.
Time up! Time up! Meanwhile, in the shed in the orchard...
Oh, flubble blub. Oh, shall we plop to the blub for a pint?
Sounds like you've had enough already.
Holly, how well did they do?
Well, Pam and Malcolm have scored 7.
They scored 7. Yes. Time went out, 7. You scored 140. £140. Very well done. OK. Thank you, Murray. Third set of questions for Brian and Linda. You're on £30 for each correct answer, and good luck to you. We want herbs that are commonly used in cooking in this country, all right? So herbs that are commonly used in cooking in this country, I will start you with tarragon.
Tarragon.
Dill.
Fennel.
Parsley.
Thyme.
It's just gone. Mine's just gone completely.
Time out, that was. We ran out of time. Where's the winners?
Indeed, time out, because Brian and Linda, you scored 5, ran out of time. 150 you got. There were many more you could have said, like mint, rosemary, bay leaf, bergamot, marjoram, garlic. Yuck, enough, you know what I mean? But what do we have at the end of our quiz here? We've got couple number 2 on £140, couple number 3 on £150. But once again, our quiz winners for the 6th week running, Roger Carver and Chris Simons from Essex with £500. £500. You'll buy the whole of Yorkshire, and I mean the county, pretty soon. Congratulations to you, Roger. Good luck. Look forward to seeing you next week.
Kiss
me. I get 1 a week at this rate. Good luck. Look forward to seeing them next week. Ladies and gentlemen, look forward to seeing you in just a couple of moments. Don't go too far away. There's a lot more fun on 3, 2, 1. Try and do that. See you then. Two of 3, 2, 1, as once again we say goodbye to our quiz winners, Roger Carver and Chris Simons from Essex, taking back with them another £500. On my reckoning, that's about 2,300, isn't it? Have a great week. We look forward to seeing you next week. But ladies and gentlemen, we started with 3 couples. We now have 2. They're standing over here, preparing to watch our first sketch and remember all they can about it. Now, the theme of this week's show is horror. And what more suitable vehicle could there be for our disreputory company other than a Black Mariah? Incidentally, anybody at home of nervous disposition, this first sketch is an X. That's not a certificate, it's the signature of the fellow who wrote it. He wants no publicity.
Your grandfather brought us back from the swamp, isn't it, Zelda?
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, Grandpa. You too, Grandma.
Poor old Grandma.
Yes, just think, someplace, somewhere tonight, she's running around, filleted. Oh, there's your father, in one of his rotten moods again. He must have got up out of the wrong side of the grave this morning.
I won't have it. It's monstrous. Just the thought of it makes my blood run warm.
Calm down, Boris. What's the matter?
Calm down? How can I calm down when I find my daughter's planning to marry a human being? You know, mixed marriages I do not like at all.
Oh, you're so right. If you're so keen to get married, I'm sure your father could dig up someone of your own kind.
Sure I can. Where's my garden spade? I'll soon get you a man.
But, Papa, I've already turned 21.
With the right makeup, you could turn more men than that. That's the trouble with you, daughter. You don't make the worst of yourself.
Yeah, what's the matter? Have you got an inferiority complex or something?
Oh, no, on the contrary. I enjoy being a ghoul.
It's a pity you're not a little bit more like your Aunt Letitia here. She even frightens me. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's better.
someone at the door.
It's my boyfriend. I'll let him in.
Yeah, let him in by all means, but under no circumstances are you going to marry him.
Well, why don't you meet him first? Come in, Enoch.
Thank you. I think you should all be repatriated to Transylvania.
Ha! I changed my mind. Of course you can marry him. He's one of us.
Okay, folks, come on round here. Will you come round here and join me here at the table? Now then, fellas, I hope you really were observing there, because, fellas, in front of you here, there are ten questions on that last scene. Fellas, while you're answering those questions, ladies, if you will come with me, just here. Here we are. In front of you there, as you can see, we've got a pair of gallows, right? And hanging from them are special balloon spiders. Now, there's a point to this game, and it's on your head. Can you see it? What we want you to do is to burst those balloon spiders. Now, there are three whistles in this game. On the first whistle, you start. On the second whistle, you change places with your partner. And on the third whistle, you stop, come back to the table, we'll add up the scores, and the winner will go through to take it or leave it and the big prizes. George is here with the whistle. Everybody all set? Good luck to you all. Three, two, one. Off you go. Go on, jump a bit higher. Okay, come on, change places. Come on, fellas, start bursting those spiders back there. Answer the questions, ladies. Oh yes, on the rebound, you got that. Come on, back to the table. Time's up. Thank you, George. Let's see how you got on. Thank you. Yes. Now, come on, let's answer your own questions and see how you got on. You did pretty well there. Now, the first question was, I hope you were looking at home because the questions did come up at the bottom of the screen, so see how well you did. The first question was, what was the daughter's name? Her name was Zelda. Did you get that? Good, the pair of you did. What was the father's name? His name was Boris. Oh, you didn't get that. Oh, yes, you did. Who brought back the clock? Grandpa did. No? Oh, yes, good, good. Who was running around filleted? Grandma. No. Skeleton, well, that'll be okay. That was Grandma. Yes, we'll allow that. Was the daughter's dress patterned? Yes, it was. Good. What time did the clock strike? 1:00. Good. What was inside the clock? A skull. No? What did you get? No? You got one. Oh, the clock? Oh, that was the last one. That's it. Come on, score quicker. What kind of numerals did the clock have? Roman numerals. Yes? Now, was the father wearing a tie? No, he was not. Now, the last question was, how was the room lit? With candles and torches. Yes? Fair enough. What did you get? Candles? You got candles? We'll let both of those go through, of course. 8 you have there. 8 here, so it all depends on how many of those spiders were burst. All right, Gail, how many did your couple get rid of?
Mine got rid of 9.
9. 9 and 8. That's right. That's 17. How about yours, Monet?
My couple's caught 4.
4 and 8 are 12. Ah, so you're the winners. You're going through to take it or leave it and the big prizes. Well done. Congratulations. Oh, Brian and Linda. Congratulations. Good luck to you. It was marvellous sports coming on the programme. Nobody loses here. You've got your...
£150.
Yes, £150 you won in the quiz. That's not a bad night's work at all, is it? Take that. Here's your... Oh, she's got it. You see that? It's going to be a good trip home for them tonight. There's your silver photo frame. Photograph was taken to you. It will be in the post to you in a day or two. Thanks a lot. Weren't they a great couple? Give them a ripple. Thank you, Brian. Thank you. £140 you won in the quiz. Now, would you like to take that now, or will George look after it for you?
George.
They're trusting her every week. All right, George, thank you. Now, come over here to Ted's treasure table. Pamela, if you'd like to stand just there. That's right. And Malcolm, if you'll stand there. Could you take rid of all the debris? Thank you very much, George. That's fine.
Can I just take that one over?
That as well? Yes, you can.
Thank you.
Because, folks, this is where it really starts for you. The money that you won in the quiz is only part of your winnings tonight, because here we want you to be sort of detectives working out clues associated with prizes in our sketches. Now, there are 6 sketches, of which you've already seen one. And there are six prizes, five super ones, including the car, and the booby prize, the dustbin. You've got to try and figure out how to get rid of the dustbin. Now, at the end of each sketch, one of the characters will come over here to the table and leave a MacGuffin. Now, you know MacGuffin is what we call the object they leave. That could or could not be a clue. It could be a red herring, but they will read you a rhyme, which will definitely be a clue. When you have three MacGuffins on the table, I'm going to ask you to reject one. And when you've rejected five in all, the one remaining will determine the prize you take home with you tonight. So here, from the last sketch, is Dougie, looking more like the Munsters than ever. What are you going to leave, Dougie, as a MacGuffin?
Funny you should ask that. There you are. That's it's a Chinese tea caddy to make Chinese tea in. And, and I've got a rhyme for you. Don't keep looking at me like that. Suitors may pile up. I'll give them the brush. The law must be laid down to keep my house plush. Okay. I've got to shoot off now. I'm going to go and cheer Les Dawson up.
You do that like that. Thank you, Dougie. Well, there's your first MacGuffin, your first rhyme. I don't know whether that means anything to you at the moment. Not a lot. Right, well, just keep thinking about it. Push that to the back of your mind, because here comes another sketch. Shakespeare was a man who never shied away from horror. But he might have taken to the hills if he'd seen what our group have done with his three witches from Macbeth.
Swan's feather and hank of hair.
Eyes so bad to tell so rare.
Lizard's arms and spider's toes.
That's the recipe today, as Raimondo knows.
Oh, what's the recipe today, Jim?
Ah, well, I'm glad you asked that. I got a MacGuffin and a rhyme for you. If you didn't quite get that at home, I'll dash through the dough one more time. MacGuffin and a rhyme, rhyme and a MacGuffin.
And this is what you do.
Thank you, Raimondo. This indeed is what you do. You put the MacGuffin on the table and you read the rhyme, which is what I ask myself. It says, it's a goodbye wave to transport delays, causing pleasure to be often spoiled. You'll enjoy what you get and the speed, I bet, but be sure that it hasn't been foiled.
Uh-huh.
SLTBFN. So long, Ted. Bye for now.
Bye, JY. Right. Now you have two MacGuffins on the table. You've heard two rhymes. There'll be one more on the table before you have to think about rejecting one of them. Ladies and gentlemen, if you needed a doctor's prescription maybe before this sketch, I strongly advise you not to go to see the doctor concerned, because it happens to be Dr. Jekyll and his other half, Mr. Hyde.
Thank you, Dr. Jekyll. You're such a saint.
Now for the important part. This is what I've been looking forward to. Mrs. Anderson, I don't want to be interrupted this evening by anyone, not even you. Do you understand?
Yes, all right, Dr. Jekyll.
They all think that I, Dr. Henry Jekyll, am the saint. Little do they know how bored I am with all this do-gooding. None of them know that I'm really, as well as being Dr. Jekyll, I am Mr. Edward Hyde, an evil man who does nasty, horrid things, like telling tall stories to Ronnie Corbett. Giving pep pills to Val Dunican and putting handcuffs on Magnus Pike. Not even my fiancée, Barbara, knows. And now I feel in the mood for some excitement, so I shall partake of some of my secret concoction. That's the first part. Come in now. I'm changing. I bet Kojak would give a fortune for this. And Billy Connolly would be absolutely furious. Yes, Mrs. Anderson. said that you were... Get off it, woman. I told her not to interrupt. That old hag. She paid dearly for this. That's right. Now, on to more evil things.
Henry, I insist you open this door.
Now you can't see me now, like this.
It's all right. I already know about you being fiendish, tyrannical, and nasty, but it doesn't matter. I still want to be your bride.
Why, Barbara? Why?
My mama said I gotta marry a doctor.
Thank goodness, that's so.
Hi, Bill, that was a quick shave. What did you do, take the antidote? Lovely to see you again.
Thank you.
Everybody always remembers you, of course, from The Great Dr. Finlay, which is still running on Sound Radio, a new series, I believe.
Yes,
great, great series. You did The McKinnons. Oh. And what are you up to at the moment?
Well, I've just done 9 parts of a serial called Kidnapped by Robert Louis Stevenson, which is going out on HTV later this year.
You're leaving that as the MacGuffin, aren't you?
Yes.
Or being Scots is the MacGuffin?
That's right.
A glass of liquid. Have you a rhyme for these?
Yes, I do. I make people suffer, but keep them fit in this place where they sit and lie. But they come back for more, because they adore to be where it's so hot and dry.
Uh-huh. Now, what does that mean to you? You're thinking now, I can see them clicking around. Lovely. Bill, thank you very much for the MacGuffin and the rhyme. And thanks so much for coming. It was terrific seeing you again. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Simpson. Thank you, Bill. Lovely. Well, there we are, Pam and Malcolm. You've just heard that one from Bill. I'm allowed to read you the Jimmy Young cookbook again, or the Chinese tea caddy from Dougie. Which would you like to hear?
The tea caddy.
You want to hear the tea caddy? That came from the first sketch, The Horror Family. It said, her suitors may pile up, I'll give them the brush. The law must be laid down to keep my house plush. So what would you like to reject? You have to reject one of them right now. Which will it be?
No. Not yet.
Not yet.
Shall we get rid of Jimmy Young?
We're going to reject the Jimmy Young recipe book. All right. I don't know whether to be too happy about that. Nevertheless, let's see what it is you have rejected. Right. Now, what kind of pleasure is so often spoiled by delays in transport? Your evening meal. It's either burnt or overcooked, right? But with this prize, it probably wouldn't have happened because, as the rhyme said, you'll enjoy what you get and the speed, I bet. But be sure it's never been foiled. A what?
A microfilm oven?
A microfilm oven? I've never heard of one of those. Well, anyway, it's something you mustn't use foil in or any other kind of metal, but which will cook your evening meal or any other meal for that matter. You're right, in rapid time, you have rejected £470 worth of microwave oven. Yes, you got it. What a shame. It came just a little bit too late, didn't it? Is there anything... Oh, a lovely, yes, a cooked chicken. Done in about 30 seconds, eh? Fantastic. You've rejected it. Never mind, there'll be more prizes on the table any minute now. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going away just for a couple of moments. We'll be back soon. 3, 2, 1. Don't leave us. See you then. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to part 3 of 3, 2, 1, where Malcolm and Pamela have just rejected a microwave oven worth £470. A great prize that was, huh? We're going to have another sketch right now. You know, when it comes down to talking about people who come out at night and long teeth, who do you think about? Esther Ranson? No. Dracula. Now, when Esther shows her teeth, that's life. But when Dracula shows his teeth, that's death. And Dracula has risen again.
Thank you.
Look at the muck on here. There must be a draft from somewhere. Everard, shut that tomb. I feel like death warmed up. Do you know, I've been in there so long. Well, you know me, I'll try anything once.
Well, of course.
Twice if I like it. I've been in there so long, I've got it all down this side.
Well, what have you brought for these people for a MacGuffin?
A MacGuffin? Oh, I know what I've got. Yes, look. I'll leave you these teeth.
Oh.
All right. They're not mine, they're Vampire Vera's. She won't need them. She's not on nights this week.
Have you got a rhyme for them too, please?
Yes, I have. Yes, I have. I know your face ever so well. It says, you must put something in me. Did you write this? Is anybody's for a donut? You must put something in me, but if you do not, what a waste of a prize we all use a lot. Mm. All right? Before I go, can I say just one thing?
What's that?
I just want to thank our director upstairs. Thank you, Millie. Thank you, all the viewers, for watching. Ta-ra, and I love you very much.
I've heard of being out for the count, but there's a count who's out for it. Okay, three MacGuffins on the table. You've heard that one from Dracula. I can read you the tea caddy again if you want it, or I can read you Bill Simpson's Liquid in the Glass. What would you like to hear? Dr. Jekyll and Hyde.
Tea caddy again.
You'd like to hear the tea caddy again, would you? All right, the tea caddy from the horror family said, her suitors may pile up, I'll give them the brush. The law must be laid down to keep my house plush. So, there you are. It's rejection time. You have to get rid of one. Which will it be?
Come on, kid. This is the end of the perfect friendship.
Right, okay. That one, the teeth.
Oh, the last one. You want to get rid of the teeth? Unanimous on that?
Yes, she is.
Yes. It's a one-way business, isn't it? Well, always a few saying, oh, no, don't. You know what this is? What do you think it might be? Oh, you think it might be a car? Well, shall we find out? Dracula said you must put something in me, but if you do not, what a waste of a prize. We all use a lot. Well, we will find exactly what it says. You've rejected Dracula's teeth. The rhyme said you may put something in me, and it's something we all use a lot. Well, what do we all use a lot that we have to put something in? Could that be a car, as they say, or a fridge, perhaps a wardrobe or a cocktail cabinet? But the word we hope you'd seize upon is the third line of the rhyme, what a waste of a prize. The word waste is what you put this particular thing in. We all use a lot. You have rejected tonight's booby prize, our old mate Dusty Bin. You've done it. Well, look at Dusty. Everything's weird on this show tonight. Even he's gone bats. Look at that. Well, what has he got in here? Hello. Yeah, must have come out of the scullery. Okay. Take him away. He's been rejected. Thank you very much, Holly. Well done, Malcolm Pamela. You got rid of it. That's the object of it, to try and figure it out.
Okay, so...
So, we got rid of the dustbin. Is there a car on the table? There's more to come yet. We're about to find out. Because with the horror of our theme of our show this week, fear is a key part of that, of course. And here's somebody who puts fear in the hearts of many people who compete against him. It's the Mr. Sheen who cleans up the prize money on the motorcycle tracks all over the world, Barry Sheen. Yes. Very nice to see you. That's the thing, that's the MacGuffin you're leaving in your helmet, is that right?
That's it.
I see. Great to have you here, Barry. Really.
Thanks.
You know, Jim, it's marvellous that you being here, because I feel that lots of people say, oh, that's a great life. It must be. Obviously, it's got to be a nice life. But I mean, you must work hard, harder than all of us, you know. How many races a year do you do?
I have to do about 25 races, and then in the winter I have to rush around and work for sponsors and all over the show.
Great. Listen, Barry, one of those bikes of yours, I mean, how much would they cost to sort of build, you know?
Oh, they cost about £7,000 or £8,000.
£7,000 or £8,000 for a motorbike.
Luckily enough, I don't have to buy them anymore. So thank God.
Barry, great to have you here. Really, that's going to be your MacGuffin object, right?
That's it.
And have you got a rhyme for these lovely people?
Yeah, I certainly have. If you win this prize, you'll use both hands. You'll certainly get twos of the bar. Some people connect it with evil, but you're not likely to go that far.
Ah, there you are. Does that mean a great deal?
It doesn't help a lot.
How about you,
it?
Barry? Does it mean much to you?
No, not a lot.
You and me both. Put it down. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Barry Sheen. Thanks, Barry. Thanks for having me. What do you think it could be?
Oh. Don't know. No, won't commit myself.
Well, I can read the Tea Caddy again if you want to hear it, or Bill Simpson's Liquid. What would you like to hear?
The Liquid.
The Liquid, please. From Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. It says, I make people suffer, but keep them fit, in this place where they sit and lie. But they come back for more, because they adore to be where it's so hot and dry. Now, what do you think? What do you think it is?
Holiday.
Oh, do you?
Sauna.
Really? Holiday? What did you say?
A sauna.
A sauna.
A sauna?
They say a holiday, you say a sauna. You have to reject one. Which one will it be?
Well, that one. You've made your mind up.
Yes, Malcolm's made his mind up. Are you going along with that,
yes,
Pam?
Yes.
All right, you're rejecting then. A glass of liquid from Bill Simpson, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. The rhyme referred to a place that's hot and dry. Well, perhaps that did make you think of travelling away from this cold, wet summer to a nice, hot, dry place in the sun. That's what those people thought over there. But that wouldn't have been necessary, because the object of this prize is to keep you fit, give you the luxury of relaxing in the place that's hot and dry in your own home to suit you at any time. You have rejected your right, Pam. Your very own sauna installed in your home. Now you try and buy that for under £850. Oh. Look at this. Yeah, you've got a good cheer from the fellas. Goodbye, it's been a good show, folks. I'll enjoy it. Isn't that a marvellous prize?
Yes,
you're absolutely right then, Pam, right
yes,
on the nose. And you liked it now, wouldn't you?
I really love it, yes.
Never mind, unfortunately, you've rejected it. You listened to Malcolm, huh? OK, Gail, take it away, fellas. Off you go. They've rejected it. Bye. Bye, Gail. Our final sketch takes place in ancient Egypt, the land of the pharaohs, where people were wrapped in bandages and left for years. It's known today as the National Health Service. It's not really, it's the chilling tale of the mummy's curse.
Oh, this is fantastic, my dear. We've stumbled across a hitherto undiscovered tomb.
Oh, how exciting, Professor. Who do you think it is?
Oh! I don't know. I'll try and read the hieroglyphics. It says here lies the body of the famous Egyptian charioteer, Tut and Pass. He lost his license and became the first Egyptian male stripper.
There's nobody there.
I think he's gone on his holidays. He's forgotten to cancel the milk. What does that say on that wall?
I wonder if he'll respond to music.
I've seen some strips in my time. How about that one? Oh, Professor, have we got a MacGuffin for these lovely people here?
Yes, that was nice. That wasn't invisible assets, that's
yeah,
cool.
Really.
There's a glove.
Before you start there, Doug, do me a favour. Ladies and gentlemen, you don't know about this, but Doug, in fact, is leaving us here tonight. He's been here for 6 shows with us. But we're all a bit sad, but don't worry. He's coming back on your screens very soon. He's going to do his own situation comedy series on this channel called Take My Wife. Is that it, Doug?
That's right, yes.
Great.
Yes.
We wish you all of the luck in the world. We really do. We mean that.
Thank you.
And here from all the people at Yorkshire is a ceramic dusty bin for you to remind you of us. How about that? Give him a little, folks. Nice and bad. Now, there's the MacGuffin, and he's going to cry through your eyes.
If you could see all of this prize, there'd be parts of white and red. A part for the foot, and another for the head. Huh? Okay?
Think. Doug,
thank you very
good
much.
Good luck.
Pleasure.
Congratulations.
To
look thank forward you. To seeing you. Dougie Brown, ladies and gentlemen. See you, Dougie. Good luck.
Well, there you are. That's the last rhyme. I can read the helmet or the tea caddy. Which would you like to hear?
The helmet.
Do you like to hear Barry Sheen's helmet? Yes. That's it. If you win this prize, you'll use both hands. You'll certainly get two to the bar. Some people connect it with evil, but you're not likely to get to go that far. You're not likely to go that far. So, what do you think?
That one. The helmet. Rejected.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
You sure about that?
Mm. Yes.
Okay. You're going to reject Barry Sheen's helmet. Let's see what you rejected this time. The prize that goes with it, the rhyme said you'd use both hands, which you'd probably need to pick up the dustbin. We know the dustbin's gone. But it also mentioned a bar, and there's no bar on a dustbin, of course. But what about the line that said some people connect it with evil? Well, evil in this case is spelled E-V-E-L, as in Evel Knievel, the stuntman who uses a vehicle in which you have to have both hands on the bar, the handlebar. So what you've rejected is a motorbike. Not one, one each. You've rejected two brand new motorbikes. Now, what about that? Anne, Malcolm, would you have liked a motorbike each?
Yes.
Yes, if I could have the little one.
Oh, if you could, oh, you'd
if
have
the little one.
You could have argued that with him. Never mind. Okay, girls, they've rejected them. Yeah. Off go two smashes on two smashes. Away you go. What a prize that was.
Yeah, all right.
Beautiful. Great prize.
So it's decision time.
So there we go. Barry Sheen's helmet's gone. We've got two MacGuffins on the table. I can read you both of them. Do you want to hear that? You've heard this so many times. You've really stuck with this tea caddy, haven't you? Suitors may pile up. I'll give them the brush. The law must be laid down to keep my house plush. That was the tea caddy. And from the mummy, Dougie left that from the stripper sketch. If you could see all of this prize, there'd be parts of white and red. A part for the foot and another for the head. So, the dustbin's gone, some fabulous prizes. You worked out the sauna, you worked out. You worked out the dustbin pretty well, anyway. And there's a car there somewhere. So, this is the one, isn't it? This is the one that's going to make it happen. What do you reckon, Malcolm?
Oh.
The tea caddy.
What do you folks think? Any idea which one it could be?
Help.
Give him some help. Go on.
Tea caddy?
The tea caddy. Tea caddy?
Well, that's what they say. Okay. Right. What does she say is what you should be concerned with. Really?
Yes, rejected.
You're definitely going to do that, Mal?
Yes.
All right. You are rejecting the tea caddy. Let's have a look. Suitors may pile up. I'll give them the brush. Well, things piling up and the use of a brush could refer to a dustbin, but it couldn't in this case. The third line made mention of something being laid down. And, of course, you could lay down a dustbin, but that wouldn't be the thing to keep the house plush. But what would keep it plush is laid down, has a pile, and is regularly brushed. You're right again. You've rejected one of the finest types of carpet in the world, £1,250 worth of handmade Chinese carpet. Look at this. Gosh, that really is something else, isn't it?
It really is.
Now, what are we going to do, Pam? Well, what do you think's here? We got a few tricks on this show. Anything could happen.
That's what worries me.
Yeah. Well, you think it could be, couldn't you? I better open it up. Rhyme said if you could see all of this prize, there'd be parts of white and red, a part for the foot and another for the head. So if it's what we all think it is, let's see how we got to it, shall we? The rhyme said the prize had parts of white and red, supply of wine maybe. Good. Let's come back to that. It also said something for the foot. Well, what's a part of the foot? A boot? Another for the head? A hat? A bonnet? What has a bonnet with a head under it? And boot, the parts of white and red? They're the lights, of course. Yes, you won tonight's star prize, the car. You won it. Yes, yes. George, he's driven it in. Out you come, George. Pam, Malcolm, get in. There we are. Come in. Malcolm, come in. No. I'll open this side. You can come round this side and get in. How about that? They've actually won the car. They're now arguing over who's going to drive the car. That's great, isn't it? I think we'd better push it out of the studio. Ladies and gentlemen, we're coming back next week. We're not going to wait a week. We're coming back next Friday night. We look forward to seeing you then. Lots more fun, big star guests and prizes on 3, 2, 1. We'll see you then. Take care. Goodbye, everybody.